Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back. And if you are new here, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real-world coding experience. And this is Hong, the coding expert. If you want to pass any coding exam to start your coding career, or if you are already holding a coding credential, working in the field, and want to learn more in order to advance your coding profession, then you are in the right place. As you already know, advanced medical technologies have changed societies and life of individuals across the world. For example, smart inhalers for asthma patients, robotic surgery for complex procedures that are otherwise highly difficult or impossible, artificial organs. Scientists have been able to create blood vessels, synthetic ovaries, and even a pancreas. Recently, telehealth, the use of technology to deliver healthcare service at a distance during the COVID-19 pandemic has been developed. Due to social distances, instead of waiting for face-to-face appointments with their doctors, telehealth allows patients to receive medical care through their digital devices. Having said that, as a medical coder, you also need to keep up with these advanced medical technologies in order to code efficiently and accurately. Therefore, lifelong learnings for our coding career is very important. Passing coding exams and having credentials are a great start, but don't stop there. You should keep learning and keep growing. Today's topic is CPC, COC, CCS, and CCS-P exam prep in 2021. The radiology services. You will have a chance to code radiology exams and procedure, which you need to know for the coding exam and also for work. All right, without further ado, let's get right into it. Question number one. What is the correct CPD code to use for the procedure? X-ray, including fluoroscopy of larynx for foreign body. Foreign body injection is less common in adults than in children, but still occurs. In adults, fish and chicken bones are the most common foreign body types, and the oropharynx and pharynx use are the most common locations. Intentional foreign body injection often occurs among patients with psychiatric disorder, and I believe it's happened in this case, a safety pin stuck in the throat. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, larynx, X-ray, it will give you just one code, 70370. Your next step is to double check this code in the tabular list, and because 70730 is an identical, so I will show you its pairing code. 70360, radiologic examination, neck, soft tissue. 70370. This is an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above. 70360, which is the pairing code. Except 70370 is for pharynx or larynx, including fluoroscopy, and this is the right code to use for the procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 70370. Question number 2. What is the correct CPD code to use for the procedure? Chest X-ray, PA, AP, and lateral. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. If you look under the main term, chest, then x-ray, it will instruct you to see x-ray, chest, and it will give you a code range 71045 to 71048. Your next step is to check these available codes in the tabular list and hear what you get. 71020, radiologic examination, chest, single view. 71047. This is identical, so it includes all the information from the cover bowl. 71020, which is the parent code, except 71047 is for chest x-ray 3 views. Based on the question, 3 views are taken: PA, posterior anterior, AP, anterior posterior, and lateral. So 71047 is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 71047. Question number 3. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? X-ray, neck, 5 views, including oblique and flexion. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, spine, x-ray, cervical, it will give you three codes: 70240, 72050, and 72052. Your next step is to review these available codes in the tabular list and hear what you get. 72040, radiologic examination, spine, cervical, 2 or 3 views. 72050, this is unidentical, so it includes all the information from the cover bowl. 72040, which is the parent code, except 72050 is for 4 or 5 views. And this is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 72050. Question number 4. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Elbow arthrogram, radiological supervision, and interpretation. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause video and do it now. All right, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, arthrography, elbow, it will give you just one code, 73085. Your next step is to double check this code in the tabular list and hear what you get. 73085, radiologic examination, elbow, arthrography, radiological supervision, and interpretation. And this is the right code to use for the radiological supervision and interpretation of the elbow arthrogram only. If the physician is also the person who injects the contrast material for the elbow arthrogram, then you need to add 24220 injection procedure for elbow arthrography. But it's not mentioned in the question, so the correct answer to this question is 73085. I want you to take note before we move on to the next question. Question number 5. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Barium enema with KUB. A barium enema is a type of X-ray imaging test that allows doctor to examine your lower intestinal tract. The barium solution will be delivered using an enema, a process in which the doctor pushes a liquid into your rectum through your anus. The barium solution helps to improve the quality of the X-ray image by highlighting certain areas of tissue. It allows the radiologist to see your internal organs in motion by tracking the flow of the barium solution to your intestinal tract. By the way, KUB stands for kidney, ureters, and bladder, which may or may not visualize as part of barium enema. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term barium enema, it will give you two codes, 74270 and 74280. Your next step is to review these two available codes in the tabular list and hear what you get. 74270, radiologic examination, colon, including scalp, abdominal, radiograph, and delay image when performed single contrast, e.g. barium study. And this is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 74270. For those of you who is planning to take the CCS exam, which is the hardest exam to pass, and that is why CCS credential is considered the gold standard for facility or hospital coding. In order to pass the CCS exam, you have to know the IC-10-CM code set, the IC-10-BCS code set, and CPT-HCPCS code set. Also, unlike CBC exam, in addition to the multiple choice question, the test also includes a fill in the blank portion. In other words, you have to know the surgery and procedure very well in order to find the right PCS code for inpatient cases and CPT code for outpatient cases. Having said that, watching my videos and practicing coding case study like this will help you prepare for the CCS exam. In addition, if you are coding in the real world, nobody gives you multiple codes to choose from, like the CBC exam. You have to read the op report, understand what they are doing, then use your CPT book or coding software to to find the right call for each record. And believe it or not, your call will determine the hospital reimbursement. In other words, how much money the hospital will receive for those services. Now you know why I want you to practice coding this in my training videos to prepare you for the CCS exam and also for work. Let's continue to the next question. Question number 6. What is the classification to use for the procedure? Intravenous, pyelogram with KUB and tomograms. Intravenous pyelogram, IVP, is an X-ray exam that used on injection of contrast material to evaluate your kidneys, ureters, and bladder and help diagnose renal stone disease or pain in your side or lower back. Again, KUB stands for kidneys, ureters, and bladder. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CBT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term, urography intravenous, it will give you just one code, 74400. Or you can go directly to the main term, pyelogram. It will also give you the same code, 74400. Your next step is to double check this code in the top of the list and hear what you get. 74400 urography pyelography intravenous with or without KUB with or without tomography, and this is the right code to use for this procedure whether or not tomograms are performed. That said, the correct answer to this question is 74400. Question number 7. What is the correct CPT code to use for the procedure? Ultrasound, pregnant uterus, third trimester, twins. If you want to call a pregnancy record correctly, then you have to know about the weeks of trimester. First trimester, less than 14 weeks. Second trimester, 14 weeks to less than 28 weeks. And third trimester, 28 weeks until delivery. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CBT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term, ultrasound, obstetrical, pregnant uterus, it will give you a code range, 76801 to 76817. Your next step is to review these available codes in the top of the list and hear what you get. 76805, ultrasound, pregnant uterus, real-time with image documentation, fetal and maternal evaluation after first trimester, retinal or equal 14 weeks, 0 days, transabdominal approach, single or first gestation. As long as the ultrasound is performed after the third trimester, then you can use disco. In other words, disco can be used for both second and third trimester, so I want you to take note. Please remember. Now, based on the code description, it's only good for a single or first gestation, so you need to use an add-on code 76810 each additional gestation, because the question mentioned it is a twin pregnancy. That said, the correct answer to this question is 76805 and 76810. Question number 8. What is the correct CPT code to use for the procedure? SPECT bone scan. Bone scan and SPECT, single proton emission computed tomography, and nuclear imaging techniques typically used together when viewing the spine. Bone scan with SPECT is particularly useful in detecting metabolic abnormalities, such as small changes in hard-to-see bones, tumors, or blood flow patterns. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, SPECT bone joint imaging, it will give you just one code, 78803. Your next step is to double check this code in the top of the list and hear what you get. 78803, tomographic, SPECT, single area, EG, head, neck, chest, pelvic, single day imaging, and this is the right code to use for the SPECT bone scan. That said, the correct answer to this question is 78803. Just a friendly reminder that if you enjoy what you have learned so far and appreciate my time spent for this video, then you could please pause the video, click the like, subscribe, and share buttons below now to support my channel, and that'd be great. I have been very busy at work lately, but I still do my best and save some time to make this learning video for you, because I really want you to pass the coding exam to start your coding career and also to equip yourself for the future of career advancement. However, I still need your support in order to keep me motivated and going. Thank you so much for your support, and we should move on to the next question. Question number 9. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Complete retroperitoneal ultrasound. An abdominal or retroperitoneal ultrasound produces a picture of the organs and all the structure in the upper abdomen, the liver, gallbladder, spleen, pancreas, aorta, both kidneys and the bladder, through the use of high-frequency sound waves that are displayed in the real-time image. It can help diagnose a number of conditions such as renal cysts, gallstones, kidney stone, pancreatitis, appendicitis, or aneurysm in the lower aorta. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, ultrasound, retroperitoneal, it will give you a call range, 76770 to 76775. Your next step is to review these available calls in the tabular list and hear what you get. 76770, ultrasound, retroperitoneal, easy, renal, aorta, nose, real-time image, documentation, complete. And this is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 76770. Question number 10. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Ultrasonic guidance for amniocentesis, imaging, supervision, and interpretation. Amniocentesis is a prenatal test in which a small amount of amniotic fluid is removed from the sac surrounding the fetus for testing. The sample of amniotic fluid is removed through a fine needle inserted into the uterus to the abdomen under ultrasound guidance. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, ultrasound, guidance, amniocentesis, it will give you two codes, 59001 and 76946. Your next step is to review these two codes in the tabular list. And because 59001 is an identity code, so I will show you its pairing code. 59000, amniocentesis, diagnostic. 59001, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the coverable. 59000, what is the pairing code? Except 59001 is for a therapeutic procedure. 76942, ultrasonic guidance for needle placement, easy. Biopsy, aspiration, injection, localization device, imaging supervision, and interpretation. And 76942 is the right code to use for ultrasonic guidance for amniocentesis, imaging supervision, and interpretation. That said, the correct answer to this question is 76942. If the physician is also the same person who performs the amniocentesis, then you need to use either 59000 or 59001. What is the difference between diagnostic and therapeutic amniocentesis? Diagnosis means the procedure is performed to evaluate fetal health or to diagnose a disease or disorder, versus therapeutic means the procedure is performed to remove excess amniotic fluid to reduce volume and pressure of amniotic fluid. I hope that you know the difference and take note. Question number 11. Follows my tips and strategy. You analyze the answer first and then read the procedure report after. A and B have the same code, 77065. So they are in the same group. C and D have different codes, 77066 and 77067, so they are in separate groups. Now you know, there are three groups, so there are three codes that you need to look up in your CPT book. 77065, 77066 and 77067. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you get. 77065, diagnostic, mammography, including computer aided detection, CAD when performed unilateral. 77066, this is unidentical, so it includes all the information from the cover bulb. 77065, what is the parent code? Except 77066 is for a bilateral procedure. 77067, screening mammography, bilateral, two-view study of each breast, including computer-aided detection, CAD when performed. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each CPT code, and after you're done highlighting, you can tell. 77065 is for a unilateral procedure, and 77066 is for a bilateral procedure. Also, these two codes are for diagnostic mammography versus 77067 is for a screening mammography. Now you know what your focus is when you read the procedure report. Let's read it. A 50-year-old female is having a bilateral mammogram with computer aided detection conducted as a screening because the patient has had a previous cyst in the left breast. Based on what I just highlighted, 77067 is the right code to use for this procedure because first, this is a screening mammogram and not a diagnostic procedure. Second, the code description already indicates that it is for a bilateral procedure. Having said that, the correct answer to this question is 77067. Question number 12. Before we tackle this case, it is very similar to what you will see on the CBC, COC, or other coding exams. You will get nervous when you see there are so many codes in the answer, or when you have to read one or two page long procedure report with so many technical terms that you don't know. As a result, you will lose your focus during the exam. That is why you must follow my backward strategy, which is to analyze the answer first and then read the report after. And I am the only one who tackle coding exam this way. Follow my tips and strategy. A and D have the same code, 73100, so they are in the same group. B and C have different codes, 73110 and 73115, so they are in two separate groups. Now you know there are three groups, so there are three codes for you to look up in your CPT book. 73100, 73110 and 73115. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book, and here's what you get. 73100, radiologic examination, wrist, two views. 73110, this is unidentical, so it includes all the information from the cover bulb. 73100, what is the parent code? Except 73110 is for a complete minimum of three views. And 73115, radiologic examination, wrist, arthrography, radiologic supervision and interpretation. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each CPT code, and when you're done, you can tell. 73100 is for an x-ray of the wrist two views, and 73110 is for a complete three view image, versus 73115 is for an arthrogram procedure. Now you should have an idea what your focus is when you read the procedure report. Let's read it. A 40-year-old man had a ground level fall when he tripped over his dog this evening on the sidewalk. The emergency department took x-rays of the left wrist in oblique and lateral views. Based on what I just highlighted, the x-ray was taken in two views, oblique and lateral, without arthrogram. So 73100 is the right code to use. We can eliminate B and C from here. Because 73110 is for three views, and 73115 is for arthrography, which do not apply. A and D still remain, and the only difference between them is that A has S52.502B and D has S52.602B. So you need to look up these two codes in your IC10CM book. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your IC10CM book, and here's what you get. S52.502B unspecified fracture of the lower end of left radius, initial encounter for open fracture type 1 or 2. S52.602B unspecified fracture of the lower end of left ulna, initial encounter for open fracture type 1 or type 2. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the key difference between these two diagnosis codes, and you can tell S52.502B is for an open fracture of the left radius, and S52.602B is for an open fracture of the left ulna. Now you should know what your focus is when you continue reading the procedure report. Let's read it. The emergency department took x-ray of the left wrist in oblique and lateral views, which reveal a display distal radial fracture, type 1 open left wrist. Based on what I just highlighted, the x-ray reveal a display distal radial fracture, type 1 open left wrist. So S52.502B is the right code to use for the principal diagnosis. That said, the correct answer to the question is A. Now you see, you don't even have to know what modified 26 is about. You still can narrow down the correct answer using my strategy. By the way, modified 26 professional component is you, because the physician only can view for his interpretation of the x-ray and the facility. In other words, the radiology department will use modified TC for the technical component, just in case you want to know. I hope that you have learned something new and valuable for coding today, not just for the exam, but also for every working in the real world of coding. That is all for now. Thank you so much for watching, for liking, and sharing this video. If you find this video is helpful, informative, and easy to learn with this format, or if you have any suggestion, then please leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate it. Also, the more positive comments that you leave for me, the better chance for my videos will be reviewed by other people. So please continue to do so. Until next time, have a great day.